Hello, my name's Anthony Hall, and in this tutorial we're going to be creating this basic Phillips head screwdriver. This is the fifth and last modelling exercise I'm going to do around tools, so let's get started. I'm using this as a reference image. I could load it in the back like I've done with some of the others, but I'm just going to see how we get on without doing that. So we'll start off by using the disc tool in the top view. I'm holding control down on my keyboard so I can make sure the size is the same all around. And then I'm pulling up the tube so I've got roughly, so I've got roughly the size I want really for the handle. So I'm going to say that maybe if we have a look, something like this. Let's add some segments, and again it's up to you. What I'm trying to do is I'm just going to make some kind of basic shape like this, go around, maybe add the little hole there, and then we'll make the end and the top. So let's say this. So I've got six sides. We can add more if we need be. So our space bar to drop it. Let's, in the side view here, look in the right view, I'm just going to make sure I'm on points, and I'm going to right mouse click and lasso around the points. Jump to the move tool. Hold control on the keyboard. Let's just move this up so we've got like a top there. So I want a row of an edge row round close to the top, so when we sub patch it there's a closer curve. So let's deselect that. So I'm deselecting and reselecting and moving these edge loops around to where I want to manipulate the shape. So we'll put one there, and you can change it if you want over time and decide on yourself. So again, I'm just literally selecting the points and using the move tool. I'm holding control down on my keyboard to stop it going sideways so it locks to the place I want to go. And again, just kind of making this up as I go along, decide what kind of handle I want. Let's bring that here. Now I've decided I want another row here of another edge loop. So what I'm going to do is a few things you can do, but I'm just going to select two polygons, making sure I'm on polygons, and just go to multiply, and let's go to bandsaw, and it'll add that extra row there. And again, you can bring up the numerical and add more if you want by going on to add and clicking. We can uniform it, ununiform it, so it's they're all the same. And then I've got close the tool down, space bar to drop it, and forward slash to drop the actual selection. So go back to points. Let me move this one down like I did before, with the top to the bottom, to about there. And then I'll select both of these, and we'll move these down to about there. So at this stage it's a matter of deciding which parts you want to come out and which parts you don't of the actual handle. So I'm going to start with the top, these two rows here, sorry, and let's go to modify size, make sure it's on local at the action centers here, and we'll just pull it out so you get this shape. Okay, and then we'll space bar and drop that selection, and then we'll do the same with these three here, look close to the bottom, and again size, and bring these out and also bring them up a bit like so. So let's just deselect these two outer ones with the middle one, and again just bring it out a little bit. And let's say that. So let's just sort of patch it. So at the minute we'll have a slight problem with the sub patch because of the flat top and bottom, but yeah, we'll press tab key and it's telling you there's a problem. But the shape is not that bad. Now, why it's like this, you can decide if you want to manipulate it in even more. I mean, what we could do is let's just select these, right mouse click, select the top, these like two here, and let's just make them come out a little bit more, let's say that. And if we want, we could select the middle and bring them in a little bit more. It's up to you how you want to do this, but anyway, let's sort the bottom out. So what I'm doing is going to go to polygons, select the bottom, and let's try multiply. Let's just try rounder, click N on your keyboard. And so what I'm going to do is, let's see the insert distance to about there. Now it's currently set to 5. You can decide how many you want with this and how far, but I don't need that many. This will probably do like this. I can live with that. Let's drop it, and we've still got the flattened edge here. So what we'll do is we'll bevel it in. So I'm using the bevel tool under multiply, holding control and dragging it in to about there. And why it's like that, you could just pull it down a little bit, give it a little bit of an oval with the move tool, which selected, you know, to give it that kind of oval bottom a little bit. And then for the bottom bit here, you could just go under multiply, you could just go to more and make pole, and that will just bring it in like so. Okay, so you've got that shape. And then if we sub-patch it, it's all looking all right still. And again with the top, what I'll do is we'll select the top polygon and we'll just bevel it in to roughly the size of what we think the screwdriver top part's going to be. So let's say that size roughly, so we'll leave it like that for the time being. I don't like how harsh this edge is, so let's select a couple of edges. So edges at the bottom look, and I've holded shift and selected two. We'll go to select loop, and then when we've got the loop round, let's use chamfer, and we'll just chamfer the top a little bit. Then I'm going to drop the chamfer tool and reselect it. You could just right mouse click and chamfer it again, just so we get that. And so we've got like a nicer kind of top bit there. Okay, so there's a basic kind of handle. I mean, we said we're going to put a hole down here, so what I'm going to do is make a squarer like hole here. So what we'll do is I'm going to select two points in a row here of this row look, and then I'll loop it, and then I'm going to use the move tool and I'm going to bring it up. And then obviously it's going to manipulate the size, the shape, which if you want, some of these have got metal bottoms, you could do that, but let's just size that out so it's roughly where it was. So what I want to do is, let's say if we look at this, I just want some kind of hole at the bottom here, I'm guessing, to clip onto stuff. But let's just make sure I've centered it, and I'm just going to move this up so it's sat on the main line. And then let's have a look here. So let's use these two here. So I'm going to say these two, I'm going to go to detail, merge polys, like so. Oops. And obviously, because of the merging, it's got no continuous loop, so it's going to go like that, but don't worry about that. Because when we do this and make the hole, it'll be fine, hopefully. So look, I'm selecting the opposite two polys. Again, merging them. Then I'm selecting them facing opposite each other. I'm going to go to multiply, bandsaw, bring up and reset. Oh, in fact, before I do that, sorry, you need to go to construct and bridge, then bring up the bandsaw. Okay, so I want a segment at each side, so close to the edge like that, and then edit this one, and let's move that so it's close to the other edge, and then if you want you can add another one in the middle, it's completely up to you, like so. Okay, so when you've done it, if you watch, the inside for some whatever reason isn't subpatched, then press the tab key and drop it, you'll get your hole and it being subpatched, like so. Okay, so there's the handle. What we need to do now is the top. So let's go in a new layer, put this one in the background, and for this I'm going to use the disk tool. I'm going to draw out the area and pull up roughly how tall I want this to be. Now let's say around there. Now I'm going to bring up the numerical and switch the sides to, let's say, 12, and we'll leave 6 for the time being on the segments anyway, and just see how we get on. Okay, so there's a kind of metal top bit of the roughly in the center. So now is a tricky bit of creating the Phillips top. So first thing I'm going to do is, let's get this lined up here so I can see the top. Okay, so let's select the top poly, we'll bevel it up and in. Oh, not that far, maybe. Let's have a look. So you get this kind of shapes. Move it up a bit, like so. Once you've got the bevel like this, what we're going to do is select a point of this loop here and then miss 3 polygons out, selecting like this look. So I've selected a point, I've missed 2 points out, and then selected the next one, and then just do the same. So you should have 4 selected, like so, and you can see in the top. And then just use the move tool. If you grab the move tool, hold control and pull it down so far, let's say to about there, and what you get is this top that looks kind of like a Phillips screwdriver. Pull it down a little bit more and then drop the selection, and literally that's it. That's as far as this kind of goes. Obviously I've done it the simplest way I can. You can keep working into it, obviously texture it and so forth, but yeah, hopefully you've enjoyed this tutorial. Please share and subscribe. Check out the Redbubble store, that's in the link in the description, and head over to Lightwave Salvation, see what's going off over there, and look out for my next tutorial. Thank you.